lost child in her arms. Would you agree your concept of God is similar to my concept of the infinite spirit of creation? If I told you I wasn't a Christian, would you still agree and quite possibly be someone I can call a friend? And if after all of that, you still hate coloured skin, despise the thoughts of others, loathe at creed or disgust at the difference of sexuality, you have surely lost a wondrous haven. For an open understanding nurtures tolerance and then friendship. Thus we sculpture a kindred twine. From these twines of friendship we fashion bonds of love, and this love could say, I cherish your thoughts, even though they may bring forth a hard learning to me. I value your words, if at first I do not understand them. I admire your perspective of life as I admire the life in the oak wood of my home. Thus, the bonds are strengthened. From these bonds and twines we can assemble a protected space akin to the sheltered entwines of the willow branch, and this space can say, do not worry of your anger, for I recognize your pain. Do not shame of your tears, for I understand your hurt. Do not care of your embarrassment, for I empathize with your humiliation, for I have also trod that seemingly solitary path. And if after all of that you urge to turn your back cause you feel righteous in your facts and arrogance, then please question the demonic pain you bring upon your fellow kind, and be aware of the one who pulls the ebb and flow of the demonic tide. Understand how these dark waters can engulf us with your bitterness, anger, and hatred. Understand the drowned and putrid odor of rotten love, harmony, and innocence. And if after all of that, a glimmer of understanding caresses your heart, please return to the sheltered willow grove so we may both share your pain and shed your tears, for I have also trod that seemingly solitary path, friend. For a kindred friendship is stronger than the ancient trees of the oldest oakwood. Thus we become rooted in a contented loam, and this strength can say, we can work to bring about change, for change is the only universal constant. We can labor to cradle and love all those who suffer. We can toil in the fields of despair in the hope our voices will be heard. For we all need to tread this seemingly arduous path, and this road need not be in solitude. This road is the common ground of humanity we all share.
I sit away. There's an angel contemplate my fate. Do they know the places where we go when we're gray and old? 'Cause I have been told that salvation lets their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head, and I feel that love is dead, I'm loving angels instead. And through it, oh, she offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong, and down the waterfall. To call, she won't forsake me. I'm loving angels instead. When I'm feeling weak and my pain walks down a one-way street, I look above and I know I'll always be blessed with love. And as the feeling grows, she breathes flesh to my bones. When love is dead, I'm loving angels instead.
take me. I'm loving angels instead.
Welcome back. I'm Andy Radford, your host for the Edges Thursday show, coming from the Edges UK studio. And this is the first time the Thursday show has been streamed with the Edge TV player. If you want to listen to the archive later on, I will place the MP3 audio link on the Edges homepage and on the Thursday link page. Just go to www.theedgeam.com. We are working on a way to archive the videos, and soon you'll be able to see this broadcast in the archived videos section. And you'll still be able to download the MP3 audio files of our shows. And this about wraps up this week's Thursday show, and I would like to thank Gina Romano and her guest Petra from Canada. Don't forget to tune in to Daniel Ott's live show this Saturday night, the 1st of March 2008. It starts at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it looks like it's going to be an extremely absorbing and interesting show. Next Wednesday, tune in to Edge TV's Edge Report, and hopefully it will be a little better next time round. But don't forget, we are running this as a trial, and we are finding our way. And if you have any ideas, information, video, presentations you want to send to us for Edge TV, we would be more than happy to play them for you. My name is Andy Radford, in the Edge's UK studio. Thank you very much indeed for listening. Goodbye.
You have been listening to The Edge. To subscribe to The Edge newsletter, log on to TheEdgeAM.com. That's TheEdgeAM.com, where you can find out more about the guests and topics discussed on the air. The Edge is being brought to you by Internet Solutions, home of affordable website design and low-cost internet access. Visit Internet Solutions at es4.com. That's es4.com. Until next week, for the Edge Radio broadcast, I'm Chris Moore. See you on the Edge.